Hey, you ready? Hey, grab that right there. Are you ready?
Hey.
Is you ready?
Ready?
You say you ready?
Oh.
Whole squad ready?
Ready?
Is you ready?
Huh?
Are you ready?
Ready?
Is you ready? Whole squad ready? We came here to see Jet. What you got? No, no, no. Not on my watch.
No way.
Bring what you got. I'm going to the top.
Hey.
You can bring what you got. I'm going to the top.
Woo.
Bring what you got. Bring what you got. I'm going to the top. I'm going to the top.
Are you ready?
Wow. Wow, wow, wow. What a victory by the Wizards. Yo, what's good, Wizards fans? It's your boy, Cam Mingo. And the Wizards, surprisingly, beat the Miami Heat 123-105 without John Wall and Bradley Beal. Is this the first time in the John Wall era we went without John Wall and Bradley Beal at the same time? Y'all need to let me know, because that was impressive. What a way to end 2019, blowing out the Miami Heat. Wow. I did not see this coming. All right, let's get into it right now. Let's go. So, now, before beginning the game, the Heat, they came out aggressive. It was 8-0. I'm like, here we go. Like, he's going to blow us out because we were missing shots, even turnover. But we did manage to keep it close, but for a while though, because the four, but he kept on raining threes, especially that Duncan Robinson kid. I'm like thinking, who is this kid? But I did watch some Heat games, and I said, okay, this kid's good. He can fly a shoe. And they're talking about he could be possibly in the 3-point shooting contest this year, but let's continue on. But that first quarter, Yan Mahimi. What were you doing out there? I'm like, you were making shots that you normally miss. You're driving the hoop, getting dunks and layups and ones. I'm like, yeah, like what, 14 the first quarter? Is that the most points you had a quarter in your whole career? Like, man, like, what is going on right here? But we were still down 10 going second quarter, because we did give up threes and turnover. Maybe gave like 7-8 threes in the first quarter. But going to second quarter, we went on a 13-2 run to start the second quarter, led by Jordan Buckets, Jordan McRae. But give the bench credit with McRae, the kid Matthews, Garrison Matthews, AP-ish, especially Matthews. Woo! You were lining it up, bro, in that second quarter. You had like, what, 20 in the second quarter? Like, wow, like, after he pull up, it goes in. But you are so good at drawing foul at three point. You're like the next Jamal Crawford. Is it? If I say Jordan Crawford, but it's Jamal Crawford. Like, you're standing your legs, you know, and drawing the contact and foul. But there's one play you hit like a deep three. I'm like, woo! I'm like, we outscored the Heat 42-24 in a second. Probably our best scoring quarter we had in the entire season. And get this, Mahimi, Matthews, and McRae combined for 61 points out of 7 points in the first half without Bradley Beal. How? Like, that is remotely impossible how that happened. How, without Bradley Beal, you let Matthews, McRae, and Mahimi score that many points in the first half without Bradley Beal? Explain that to me. But in the second half, beginning, congrats, Yan Mahimi. You just passed your first 20-point game of your career, but we get to the moment. And the way they kept it going, we were rolling offensively, and the defense was good in the third quarter. I gotta admit, it was really good. It was good. It was pretty good going on our run in the second quarter. But we got 18, IT hit a three. That we're going to blow about the Miami Heat. But back in the Heat. Like, they cut to like 6 points. They went on 12 and run. And they're up 18. I'm like, uh-oh. Because you know Heat done it before. Heat team's done it before. Because even in the LeBron year, every time they're down, they storm back. You know, they don't quit. But fourth quarter, get the team credit that fourth quarter. We kept our composure. Our effort was great. We just played offensively, defense. Guys hitting big shots. Troy Brown, AP was getting some rebounds. McCray doing what he does. And Matthews and Mahimi. But think of Mahimi. He made not one, but two threes. Two. Like, it was like, the second three was corner pocket, whoop, dagger. Like, and we end up winning by 18 points. Great win, Wizards. Let's get these stats here. Three game balls, I get to three. Yama Mahimi, Jordan Matthews, and Jordan McRae. Not Jordan McRae, Garrison Matthews, I'm sorry. Garrison Matthews and Jordan McRae. Mahimi, you had 25 points. And you missed one shot. I can't remember the shot you missed, but he made a mission 2-3, but he didn't have five rebounds, though. I need more than five rebounds from you, but this, man, I didn't see this kind of mission. Y'all here, you paying for a contract, buddy? Man, ain't you gonna play out like this? Woo! That's about Garrison Matthews. 28 points, 6-8 shooting. He made 4 threes, but get this stat. He made to the line 13 times. And most of them were drawing fouls on 3-point shots. He didn't make a 4-point play, but he was going to shooting 3 free throws. But way to ball out, Garrison Matthews. Tommy Shepard, you're a genius. Pure genius. Let's get to the third game ball, Jordan McRae. 29 point. I think is that career for you? 29 point. I think it is. It's probably. I gotta check, but game most points you had in your career. 29 points, 9-point shooting, 6 of 8 from three. But he had a career high though, and it says 8 assists from. And you're a shooting guard, right? You're at 6'5", 6'6", something like that. You were the offense. You know, vouched by Bill. You're the offense. And Ish Smith, and they had, we could have three guys scoring 20 off the bench. Coulda. But he had 19 points. 19 points, 7 assists, doing a little English. I call it Ish with the swish, Ish with the dish, whatever you call it. I call it anything rhyme with Ish. I like it. Now, for the Miami Heat, Jimmy Butler, he had 27 points. 15-19 from the line, though. He was in the line a lot of time because he's known for getting to the line more than making more shots. With it, but like I said, he made more shots than he made a free throws than made shot. He was 6'10 shooting, but made 15 free throws. Now, I like this kid, Bam Adebayo. He's in line to be an all-star this year. I know he had 14-14, but this guy, could be an all-star this year and possibly a most improved candidate. I like what I'm seeing in this kid, Adebayo. I've been watching the Heat games a bit and seeing his numbers. I'm like, this kid could be an all-star this season. Now for the team stats here. The field goal percentage, the Wiz shot 51%, the Heat 45%. In the first quarter, I think he shot 60% in the first quarter. So give the Wiz defense some credit here for shutting the Heat down after that first quarter. The threes, 17 of 37 from three. That's 45% for the Wizards. And the Heat, they made like 7-8 threes in the first quarter, something like that. Tonight, they made 10. They were 10 for 28. That's 35%. So, good job on defending the three-point line, Wizards. The free throws, both teams shot the free throw line 30 times. We were 20 of 30 because, you know, I mean, missing free throws. But the Heat, they were 29 of 39. They both teams missed 10 free throws, so. But he shot bad percent. He shot 74%, but we still win the game. But the assists, I know we struggled assists the past couple games. We were in the low, like below 20 assists in the last couple games. Wiz had 26 assists. Like the ball movement was back in our favor. And he had 18. The rebound, we were -4. He had 44. The Wiz is 40. The steals, I was impressed. We've been getting some steals ever since that kid. Gary Payton II, Gary Payton's son, and he came in, our steals been piling up. Like, he's been balling. Not on offense, but defense. Like, Tommy Shepard, you're still a genius, man. Wow. Like, you're getting all these pieces that it could be around for next season. Like I said, he had 13 steals. He had 5. On the fast break, we had 18 fast break points. The Heat had 3. In the turnovers, we had 9. Good job of protecting the ball. We had 9, Heat 18. That's how you beat the Miami Heat. If you don't make mistakes, you should beat the Miami Heat. If you do, he make a pair. Just like back in the day when LeBron James. Then when turnover, don't make you pay. It's easy points. So, like I said, what a way to end 2019 with a victory against the Miami Heat, who's on a 5-game winning streak coming in. They're number 2 in the Eastern Conference, probably the most improved team in the league right now. And we were undermanned. We had like 7-8 guys playing and 7 guys hurt. No Wall, no Beal, no Wagner, no Bertans, no Bryant, Hachimura, Miles, you name it. It's like, it was like a win for the go-go, not for the Wizards. Like, then we beat the Knicks with a go-go team, plus Bradley Beal last week. Like the go-go's 2-2 now. Playing this card, I'm like, we did lose the Pistons, lost to the Knicks, we beat the Knicks, beat the Heat. We're 2-2, Cap City go-go, Wizards, not the Wizards yet because the Wizards, they're not healthy yet. Once we get Bryant, Bertans, and those guys back, we're the Wizards then. So we're going to take a quick break here. We ain't going to do no headlines, no poll, no nothing. I'm going to get to some final thoughts and shout out to my Wizards fans to end 2019. Stay tuned, Wizards.
What a win. Quarter, pass the sneaks, kick out, Matthews. Fading away along the baseline, able to hit. Difficult shot there by Garrison Matthews. Matthews, a deep three. Got it! 1-point ball game. Timeout, Miami. Here's McCray. Matthews for 3 in the lead. Got it! 14 for Garrison Matthews.
It's a great read by Jordan on the single side tag.
Smith against Nunn. Matthews for 3 again. Yes!
Oh,
17 for Garrison Matthews. Garrison Matthews, quick catch and shoot, another one. He's got 20. A chance for more. Here comes Matthews. Matthews got it. 22 for Garrison Matthews in the first half.
And we are back, Wiz Nation. Now, there's no headlines, no Wiz poll, nothing. We're just going to get to some quick thoughts and some shout-outs to some Wiz fans who've been with me throughout this process, what I've been doing for the past couple years. But let's get to these thoughts right now. Now, I know we've been struggling. We're like 10-22 in the season. I know this is not a tank season. This is like more of a rebuilding season, you know, because of all the injuries we have, but if we were healthy, we probably would have been in the 6th seed right now. I got to be honest. Or maybe 5th. Or maybe 4. If we had Wall, Beal, Bertans, Bryant, you name them all. Like I said, if we were right there, healthy, we'd probably be in making plans right now. But we're not. But the Magic, they did lose tonight. We got the Magic coming up on Wednesday night. They did lose, I think, for like 3.5 back behind them for the A spot. So, next game, beginning of 2020, it's a big game. Now, I do want to get to this real quick. You saw the video of Miami Heat. This guy named Chris Silva saw his mom first time in 3 years. That touched me right there. That really, really touched me. Like, that is amazing to watch. Seeing him react, seeing his mama in 3 years. That was a good moment there. But I want to get these shout-outs right now. First, shout-out to my boy, Trey, a.k.a. Wasn't Perfect. He was at the game tonight. He was shocked. I know you were shocked seeing them win. But they did it. They surprised you. And best luck to your Chiefs in the playoffs, too. Hope they make the Super Bowl and possibly win it. Shout-out to my man, Jeff. His son Nick, daughter Rachel, they're at the game as well. Finally, first time seeing them get a win. and end the year as well. I love it. Hope to see you at a future Wizards game one day. Shout out to my girl C-Wall from the C-Wall Entertainment. I love watching you on Thursdays on Facebook. And we know we get a lot to talk about on Thursday because, you know, with the Redskins and all that stuff and everything. But I cannot wait to hear this. This is your first show in 2020, I think. So, yeah, I cannot wait. Shout out to my man Troy from the Locked On Wizards podcast. I've been listening to you almost every time you pop up. When I'm going to work or going back home, whatever. I love hearing your news on the Wizards every day, my man. Hope to see you at a Wizards game, possibly Saturday. Shout out to my girl Victoria, huge Wizards fan. We met at a Wizards game. We played the Rockets. Great Wizards fan. Hope to see you soon as well. Shout out to long Wizards fan, my man Stephen Powers. Like, big time Wizards fan. Hope we meet up. Shout out to my man Matt. We've been talking for a bit. I love doing the Wiz extra website. I've been seeing your top 100 Wiz in a decade, so I've been debating a lot, but so far looking good. There's some positives, there's some negatives, but so far looking good. Shout out to my man Alan Wright, part of the Lockdown, not Lockdown, but the Wiz extra website. You've been doing your thing. Shout out to my boy Sean. He had a birthday this past Saturday. He was at the Wizards game when he lost to the Knicks, but didn't win. But don't worry, man. Saturday, my birthday, I will get you a win. So look out for that. And shout out to my man, Joe Turner, my man, big time DC fan. I saw your video about the Redskins. They fired Moose Allen and all that. But thank God. Season's over, man. We can finally move on to 2020, to the next season. Cannot wait. So, and shout out to my big Wiz / Eagles fan, my man Dylan, my man and Delonte, big Eagles fan. Congrats to your Eagles, even though I hate the Eagles. Congrats to y'all make it to the playoffs and AFC champions. Good luck versus Seattle. And keep the thing on the Wiz extra website as well. And shout out to my girl Becca. Keep doing your thing on the Wiz Extra website. Thank you for a Christmas card. I appreciate that. Hope to see you soon. Maybe at Wiz game or whatever. But Wiz fans, thank y'all. Thank y'all because without this, none of this will be possible. So I appreciate you guys. So that's it. Hope we're going to end this 2019 with a bang. And people I mentioned, starting next month, hopefully I will start having guests on my show coming January. So look out for me. See if y'all can make it to my show, cause I'm dying for seeing who wants to talk Wiz basketball with me. So thank y'all for watching. If you want to follow me on Twitter, it's at Cam Mingo. Same thing Instagram. For this channel on Twitter is at Wiz Unscore Nation, and for Instagram is Nation _ Wiz. Happy New Year's to y'all, and coming soon. Make sure y'all tune in for the top 10 Wiz moments of the decade that's coming soon. So look out for that. So thank y'all. Happy New Year. I will see y'all in 2020. Peace out.